The date changed to December 19, 2006, 1 year after Cat killed himself. Dog was putting a bouquet of flowers on Cat's grave. After he was finished, he ran away. It then changed to him on the sofa, smoking more weed. He looked to his left to see a picture of him and Cat side by side. The picture was dated as August 8, 1997. Dog teared up and said, "Even though I might be losing control," he paused, then said in probably the lowest voice I have ever heard Tom Kenny do, "I won't forget. I won't forget you." The date then changed to January 1st, 2007. Dog was watching the ball drop again, with a more angry expression. Once it got to zero this time, he said, "I don't need this shit. Damn." Dog was swearing like a sailor. It then changed to the date November 22nd, 2007. I think it was Thanksgiving. That was more than 10 months later. Dog was looking at the same picture, and said very solemnly, "I am not thankful, I have nothing left." It then showed a flashback of Cat getting beat up, while Dog was saying in the background he wasn't strong, but it wasn't his fault. It was those goddamn greasers. He yelled, "They killed him." Dog let out a large roar, screaming like he did when he cut himself. At this point, Sadie was wailing. She hates screaming, if I didn't mention. Instead of squeezing me, she squeezed the sofa pillow. "Hard," she said, "Danny, I need some water. I'll be back." She walked across the studio to get a water bottle from the kitchen. She instantly came back with one, because our apartment is really small. It changed to December 19, 2007, 2 years after Cat was killed. Dog was in front of Cat's grave. He held the picture of them in his hand. He looked at it, and started tearing up. Utter silence filled the room. After a bit, Dog broke the silence by growling, and saying, "I'll bring you back." He ran away with the picture in his hand. The day changed to January 1st, 2008, where Dog was snorting cocaine. He looked at the ball drop on the TV for a second, and went back to what he was doing. The date then changed to February 14, 2008, where Dog was putting up posters, saying things like, "Don't enter or I'll shoot," on the windows. He was now blocking himself from the outside world for good. I was crying like a baby. He went insane. Sadie was still shaken about when Dog screamed. We were a mess. The date then changed to May 6, 2008, where Dog was writing a note. It said, "Why should I live in a world where the only person I live for is dead?" He stuck it on the bedroom wall. He held the picture of him and Cat in his hands. He said, "Don't worry, Cat, I am coming back to you." The date then changed to May 7th, 2008, where Dog was standing on the top of the house, arms extended. He said, "This is to see you again, Cat." He fell forwards, and I wailed again. Sadie had to cover my mouth again. I was sobbing. Not only had Cat commit suicide, but now Dog as well. My childhood had officially died. The characters I grew up with had died. But what came next was what made me feel a bit better. Dog woke up on what seemed to be a cloud in the sky. His piercings were gone. A familiar voice asked, "Dog, need a hand, Dog?" A large weight lifted off my shoulders. As that was revealed to be Cat's voice, I stopped crying sorrowfully, and started crying joyfully. Cat lent out a hand to Dog, and Dog grabbed his hand. Once Dog got up, he and Cat held hands, as they were now in heaven. They smiled, as Dog said in his regular old voice, "Hi ho diggity." They teared up, and hugged each other, crying tears of joy. I was crying tears of joy, and Sadie was too. Cat Dog was reunited as one, as the screen slowly faded to black.